In this video, a very simple experiment is being performed. The apparatus required is a piece of paper and a concave mirror. You will notice that the concave mirror is kept in such a way such that the sunlight falling on it is reflected. Now the piece of paper is moved about till a sharp and bright spot of light is obtained. You will notice that when this sharp and bright spot is obtained, the paper starts burning. So what do you think is happening over here? Why is this bright spot of light that is so small causing the paper to burn? Let us find out. Consider this animation. In this animation, we find that a concave mirror has been kept. The light rays that are coming from the sun are coming from a very far distance. So these light rays are always parallel to one another. So when these light rays parallel to one another hit the concave mirror, you find that they converge at a point. Now notice, when you perform the experiment, the mirror has to be kept in such a way such that the principal axis of the mirror is parallel to the incoming light rays. When this is the case, what do you think happens? The incoming light rays converge at a point on the principal axis. This is the point where all the heat from the light rays that are coming in gets concentrated, and this is the point where we obtain the sharp bright light. When this point is obtained on the paper, we found that the paper got burnt. So what do you think this point is called? This point where the light rays converged and got focused is known as the focus of the concave mirror. The length from the focus of the concave mirror to its pole is known as the focal length of the concave mirror. Always remember that whenever light rays that are parallel to the principal axis are incident on the concave mirror, they converge at the point on the principal axis that is known as the focus of the concave mirror. So we found out that the light rays after reflection converged at F, which is the focus of the concave mirror. So in other words, what can we say? We can say that concave mirror is a converging mirror, because light rays after reflection are converging at a point that is known as the focus. Now let us find out what happens in the same experiment if we introduce a little twist. The twist is, in this case, instead of using a concave mirror, we use a convex mirror. And we repeat the same procedure. We keep a piece of paper in front of the mirror and we allow sunlight to fall on the convex mirror. You will be surprised to notice that when the sun rays fall on the mirror, they are not burning the piece of paper. You can move the piece of paper front and back and you will still not notice the paper burning. Why do you think this is happening? Let us find out. If you take a closer look at what is happening, you will find that when the convex mirror is kept in sunlight, the sun rays that are coming in from a very far distance are parallel to one another. Now the convex mirror is kept in such a way such that the principal axis is parallel to the incoming sun rays. Now after reflection, these sun rays spread out in the outward direction. But as you noticed with the experiment, the piece of paper kept in front of the convex mirror does not burn. Why do you think it is happening? This is because, as you can see, the rays after reflection are not converging at a point. Instead, they are spreading outwards. This is why the paper being kept in front of the convex mirror was not burning. But if you take a closer look at the image, you will notice that these rays that are spreading outwards seem to be coming from a point that lies behind the mirror. So these rays that are seeming to be coming from a point behind the mirror is known as, that is, this point is known as the focus. You will notice that in case of a convex mirror, the focus lies behind the mirror, and it is from this focus that the rays seem to be diverging or spreading in the outward direction. The length in between this point, that is the focus, and the pole of the convex mirror is known as the focal length of the convex mirror. So since we saw that after reflection from the convex mirror, the rays diverged in outward direction, we can say that a convex mirror is also a diverging mirror. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned about concave mirrors and convex mirrors and their properties when a parallel beam of light hit them. In case of concave mirror, if parallel rays are incident on the concave mirror such that the principal axis of the concave mirror is also parallel to the rays, then the rays after reflection got concentrated at a point that is the focus of the concave mirror. And in case of a convex mirror, what happened? Well, in case of a convex mirror, after these parallel rays that were also parallel to the principal axis of the convex mirror hit the convex mirror, they spread outwards after reflection. In other words, they diverged after reflection. These rays seem to be coming from a point that lied behind the mirror. That point is called the focus of the convex mirror.